Imagine getting up in the morning, heading to the kitchen, flicking on the kettle, ready for that non-negotiable cuppa, popping on the toaster, and nothing happens. You check the fuse box, and no circuits have been thrown. What's going on? Every chance the issue is not here, but somewhere out there. Kym Williams, SA Power Network's reliability manager, is the ideal person to talk us through the important subject of outages.
Yep, so that's the automation.
The main cause of power outages is actually vegetation around our power lines. So we clear vegetation to the required clearances. However, vegetation, especially in the metro area, is allowed to overhang our power lines. And therefore, when we get a windy day, branches come down on our power lines and cause outages to our customers. We'll assess that location. And a lot of times we'll actually go and install line covering by putting the insulation over the wires. That allows the trees not to short out between our equipment.
What would normally happen if a tree branch hit across there?
It's no different than your safety switch at home. Basically, our switches back in our substations sense the fault and then they turn the power off.
So tree trimming is critical to maintaining power supply?
Certainly, and safety. Next cause of outages is lightning. So that's mainly in our rural areas. What we call a big lightning storm for us is around 25 to 50,000 strikes in a 24-hour period. The lightning basically punches through our existing old porcelain insulators. We've actually got a porcelain insulator up there. And so what's happening is the overvoltage from the lightning strike might go down the wires and it wants to go to earth, and it punches through the porcelain insulators. And that could be just a pinhole in the insulator, and we're looking at literally, you know, hundreds of kilometres of line, so it can be a real challenge.
Well, it's amazing that with all of that, the power does go back on in a relatively short period of time.
We can actually zoom in on where the lightning has occurred near our power lines to better position our crews into those locations first.
So how are you reducing the damage to those porcelain insulators?
And what we do is we've been proactively replacing the porcelain insulators with these resin insulators. The lightning will strike across the face of the insulator and we'll only have a momentary interruption of about 2 or 5 seconds to our customers, and the power will remain on, so we don't have to go out there. We've got an ageing network. The average age of our network's about 50 years old, so we actually inspect everything every 5 years and replace them before they do fail.
So it's just constant maintenance?
Day in, day out, we're always maintaining the network to ensure the safety of our network to our customers and community, as well as keeping the lights on as well.
And Kym, I believe that grey-headed flying foxes are a major problem as well.
They certainly are. They've literally blindsided us. Now that the colony is up to 37,000, they cause outages. We've got all sorts of weird and wonderful covers that we've put up on the power lines, and they're very effective in reducing both the electrocution of animals and also keeping our power on to our customers.
And what about vehicles and other accidents to poles and equipment?
Yeah, we have a lot of third-party contact with our equipment, cars hitting poles. Also, we have people digging into our cables, so it's important to contact Dole before you dig. The other one that's been escalating over recent years is farmers coming into contact with our equipment. The reason it is actually because they're using GPS steering, so it's auto-steering on the tractors. So I'm not too sure what the farmers are doing at the moment out there, but they're certainly hitting our poles and droves, and they've got to be very careful.
Kym, what's the future for reducing outages in the network?
So we're looking at new technologies, better ways to find faults. We're putting a lot more switches out on the network, which will reduce the number of customers interrupted where we do have an interruption.
And you're always busy?
We're always busy, 100% of the time, 24/7. We don't get a break.
Well, we need the power, so thank you very much.
No problems. Thanks, Kym.
With SA Power Networks currently working on their reset engagement for 2025 to 2030, there's a lot to consider and talk about when it comes to South Australia's energy future, including outages. To be part of that discussion, simply head to the Talking Power website.